All right, are we ready? Please tip me. I have my mortgage due on Tuesday. I have taxes due within a week. Outside of that, I really don't have much else to say. That takes insane practice. That's something that, it's not even muscle memory. That's like, you have to know the timing. You have to practice a lot. It depends on your skill level and who you're using. Shout out to Jax Raxer. What's going on, sir? He tipped me $10. It's good evening. All right, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to my weekly Throwback Street Fighter session. Welcome, everyone, whether you're live on stream or you're watching this on demand on DSP Gaming on YouTube. We'll get started here with some Super Turbo fun. It looks like we're fighting Ken. Good luck with Guilty Gear Strive. I'm not playing it. All right, here we go. Super Turbo, finally. Alright, it's added. You guys should be able to start using it momentarily. I just added it's nothing. So DSP nothing would be the command. DSP in the capital N, and then the rest of the word nothing. Indeed, I like the fact that I can add these emojis instantly. Fuck this. I'm seriously not wasting time tonight on that bullshit. I don't want to play laggy-ass fuck Goji tanks and waste a whole fucking multiple matches of a fucking lobby. I'll just join a different lobby and play non-laggy players. Derek says he really enjoyed when I played Killer Instinct on the Xbox One when it first launched. They eventually added a Season 2 with more characters. Yeah, you know, I liked it for like a month, remember? And then I found out how bad the online play was. That the online play was completely desynced. With things that people were seeing on the sides of the internet weren't even the same. We were just talking about this, how when you do that in a shooter, like a first-person shooter or battle royale game, that's almost commonplace and acceptable. In a fighting game, when two players are seeing completely different things on their screens, how is that a one-on-one competitive match? The problem with Killer Instinct was, it was completely desyncing.
The netcode in this game is probably the most superior of any fighting game on a console ever.
On one side, one guy would see him winning the match, on the other side, the other guy would see himself winning the match.
Killer Instinct kind of blows everything out of the water, and it's insane. And you'll keep hearing reports from people that are actually playing the game online a lot, like dudes with hundreds upon hundreds of games played, that it functions extremely well even from, like, the West Coast to the UK, the East Coast to Australia.
What the hell was that? It was proven to be broken. So I basically stopped playing it, and then you didn't really care about it anymore, because the online play sucked so bad. Later on, apparently, they patched it and fixed it, but, you know, I didn't really care about it by then. I really hate Alpha 3 with a passion. I do everything right and I get punished and I lose because the game sucks shit. It's fucking, it's such a bad fighting game. I'm sorry. So many people love it. I'm like, why do you love it? Can you give me a justification? And really, usually they can't. They can't competitively explain why they like it. Oh, I like the fucking stupid flashy V-ism juggle combos, but they're broken. Oh, I like that there's so many isms. Yeah, but most of them are broken and you can't use them in competitive play. They suck. That game is such an unbalanced fucking game and people still play it like it's a good game. It's so... out of all the games in this collection, Alpha 3 is the poorest balance. Seriously, it's such a poor game. Yet people play it like it's some great game. It's not. It's really a pathetic game. Nothing about it is anything like other fighting games. Every hitbox is a weird hitbox. Like, everything about the game is frustrating. If you play any other Street Fighters and then you play this one, you're like, what the fuck did they do here? Fucking idiots. It's so frustrating. Now I gotta play it again. I think the guy's fucking internet cut out. It did. Oh my god, come on. Oh my god, come on, dude. Get your kids off the fucking other lines, man. What are you doing, dude? Trying to play a game here. Fuck! We are not even close to hitting the tips goal at all, as you can see. We're only $33, so. Alright, this doesn't work. And then there's fucking the trolls in here anyway, and Goji tanks. Two fucking complete morons. Trying to stalk me and waste my fucking night, so I'll just leave. Idiots. King Furbs, no worries. You never have to apologize for feeling like you should be able to support more. You don't ever have to apologize to me at all for anything like that, dude. Never. I don't want anyone who comes to my streams to be like, oh man, I wish I could help Phil more or anything. No. First of all, you just being here is enough. But the fact that you go above and beyond to support the streams even further is really nice of you. So don't ever feel bad, and thank you for what support you do give, man. Thank you. Okay. First of all, you just being here is enough. Oh boy. Thank you for the tip. I just received a $10 super chat from AO, which is that new animation. How you guys like that $10 super chat animation? That's brand new. I think that's the first time we actually legitimately seen that on the stream. He says, hey Phil, I currently deliver pizzas. I make a pretty good living from tips and the generosity of others, so I'm passing it forward. Sounds good. Thank you for the support, AO. I appreciate that, man. Alright. We're at $43 in tips, guys. Please, with about an hour left on the stream, if you could contribute with a tip, I really appreciate it. We can make the vest goal happen. It would be really cool. I really need the help right now with tips moving forward for the next week to week and a half until I get paid by YouTube. So please, once I get paid by YouTube, it will be back to normal. I don't have to talk about tips anymore. But right now, I really need the help. So if you're going to support the stream, if you can tip me tonight, please do, and thank you. First of all, you just being here is enough. Yes, Only Ice Coffee, I've been streaming on YouTube for roughly a month. I would say another couple days. I think actually, if I remember correctly, it was a Saturday night that was my first actual stream going from Twitch to YouTube, because it was during the Returnal stream earlier that day they erroneously suspended my account, claiming I had done something I had not done. So that Saturday night I switched over to YouTube and never went back. So that would have been, as of tomorrow night, I believe it's 1 month. Yes. Guys, we have not even hit the Gunner Glasses goal, which really sucks. First of all, you just being here is enough. Alright, people are asking about super chats and tips and everything. Here's how it works. When you tip me, I get that immediately and it allows me to use it for important things like paying bills and the like. When you do a super chat or a membership, that helps me next month. Because the way it works is everything that you do via memberships or super chats gets tallied up for an entire month. It also gets totaled with ad revenue that I make on this channel this month, whether it's on-demand videos or ads that run on this stream, okay? All of that gets totaled up and I get paid for that around the third week of every month. So right now, if you did a $5 super chat, I would get that the third week of July, you see? It helps. Long-term, it helps. This is how it also worked on Twitch. And what I had was I had immediate income from tips and residual income coming in every month from super chats and subs. And that allowed me to pay giant bills like my mortgage and stuff. I always would use the Twitch money to pay for. While day-to-day stuff would usually be tips. But that's why right now I keep saying, gee, I really need help with tips. It's because I need funds right away to pay the rest of my bills until I get paid by YouTube later this month. That's what I mean by all that, okay? So that's the difference. I know I don't want... People were asking for it. I didn't want to talk about it. People were asking about it in the stream chat, so I wanted to explain. Okay. Okay. All right. Well, is this ending? No. We're going to have a third round. Son of a bitch. Does Stream Element take a cut from tips? No. Stream Element does not. PayPal does. PayPal, I believe, with each tip, there's a flat fee, and it's very small. The flat fee they charge is like 30 cents per transaction. But I also believe on top of that, there's a small percentage of each tip. And actually, it fluctuates dependent on region. Like, I've seen people from international, outside of the U.S., it seems to take a larger cut than, like, if you're domestic for some reason. I don't know why. Maybe it's currency conversion fee or something. It's different. I don't know exactly how it works. I just know that PayPal has fees, but they're not huge. Let's put it that way. The fee that PayPal would take is not a ginormous fee or anything like that. Okay? If you're going to ask me about YouTube, I don't even know. Like, since I've only been doing this a month on YouTube, I don't even know how much YouTube takes out of stuff. What I can tell you is this, I know this about memberships. Memberships here are the same as subs were on Twitch with their paid memberships, okay? Supposedly from what's supposed to happen. what's supposed to happen is, here, I get a bigger cut. For example, here, my base membership on a channel on YouTube here, I made it $3.99. Over on Twitch, it was $4.99, okay? But I get the same amount from a sub here as I did on Twitch. So on Twitch, I made like $2.50 a sub. I think here I make like $2.48 or something like that. So even though it's a dollar cheaper for you, I actually get the same amount as when you were subbing on Twitch because YouTube takes a smaller cut. Now, I have no idea what YouTube takes as cuts for Super Chats. Zero. No idea at all. So that I can't speak to. Okay. No, I'm not doing Venmo and I'm not doing a million payment methods. It's this simple. There's no problems with PayPal. I'm happy accepting tips via PayPal. I'm not changing my method for that. Oh, I see. So Normal Not Odd says YouTube will take 30% from the Super Chat. Twitch makes the consumer pay the cut for bits. That's right, when they buy the bits, the consumer gets that cut lost, right? I mean, essentially it's the same thing. And I think bits can be incredibly expensive from what people have said. Like, the premium to buy bits can be, like, really high. I guess it's easier to just do the Super Chat and know what it is, you know? I don't know. I'm not really tracking all this stuff. I'm just not. I'm not gonna track all this financially and see every day what I'm making. It's ridiculous. Oh, good Goji Tanks came in here. How delightful. I'm not playing Goji Tanks in this fucking laggy connection. We got about 15-20 minutes left on the stream, everyone. Thank you to everyone who's chilling with me tonight, having a good time. I appreciate it. Thanks, of course, everyone who contributed as well. Goji Tanks stalking me again. Or not Goji Tanks, excuse me. Jose stalking me again. No, I can't play Jose. He doesn't play. People are like, oh, why don't you play Jose and beat him up good? Because he doesn't play. He glitches the game out and makes it so no one can play. He knows a way to glitch the game and freeze it. So. Who can play at that slapping game? Oh! Oh, you interrupted my ass. Oh, I'm very disappointed you interrupted my ass. Oh, nice. I just got a $49 tip, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you very much to the anonymous $49 tipper. Let's get that on the leaderboard. Of course, I need to put on a vest, but now there's no time. Ha, air throw. I'm gonna hit him with some tortugas. Oh, shit. Ah. Now I got a super chat from DXP. Oh, yeah, look at that. Oh, super. Oh, I want a super. Mr. Gugatz, to me, $1.30 says, there's something about the fighting community today that burns him. Everyone used to be in the brotherhood. Now it's a lot of backstabbing. Here's what I know from like 10 years ago, all right? When I was in the fighting game community, because there was no money involved, there was no sponsorships. It was all about the love of the game. Were there rivalries? Yeah, but at the end of the day, I made a ton of friendships. I met people from all around the globe who I never would have met or interacted with outside of Street Fighter. I had a lot of fun times with people who played Street Fighter. Camaraderie, a feeling of camaraderie, okay? At some point, when YouTube blew up, when streaming blew up, and when all of a sudden it was being about being on a gaming team and having sponsorships and making money, making a living doing it, all of a sudden it just, the whole community changed. I noticed everyone online was making fun of everyone else. There were so many people who talked shit about me. I didn't talk shit about anyone because I wasn't involved with the fighting game community when games like Street Fighter 4 and the light came out. I had no aspirations to be a pro fighting game player. I outright said it in my content. I said, I am not a pro. I'm basically just someone who's having fun with this. I'm casually playing Street Fighter 4, playing with all the characters, doing these madness sets and stuff. And I was getting viral popularity on YouTube, and the pro players were pissed at me. They were actually angry at me because I wasn't playing the game at a pro level, but I was making a living making videos of fighting games. They were actually legit angry with me, and they were saying nasty fucking things about me, insulting me and shit constantly, when I didn't even know why were they doing that. I wasn't involved with the fighting game community. I outright said many times in my videos, I'm not part of the fighting game community. So I never understood that mentality of why you wanted to hate on me. I had nothing to do with it. But again, it never used to be like that. It was like, back in the day, if you just liked Street Fighter and you were good, you got respect. And that's all it was about. It wasn't about making a buck. It wasn't about who's popular and who's going to get the most views and steal the fucking what do they call it, the market share of views and streams and shit. Like, no one cared about that shit back in the day. It didn't exist. Because let's play Street Fighter and have fun, you know? And now it seems like the whole thing's completely flipped. But yeah, seriously, like, I don't know why people in the fighting game community became so angry at me when I was successful on YouTube. I think what it was is they were like, man, for us to make a living doing this, or for us to make it doing this, we have to grind, we have to go to every tournament, we have to practice like crazy, we have to go nuts doing this. But then Phil just makes casualized Street Fighter videos on YouTube and makes a ton of money doing it. How is that fair? I think they were genuinely upset about that.
And DSP still talking?
I think he just got through.
Oh, okay.
Oh, hold on. You want me to repeat it for you because you weren't on the line, brother? You don't belong there, dude.
That they had to play at a pro level. They had to work their asses off to get any kind of notoriety, to get a sponsorship, to make a living. I never had to do any of that. I just made silly videos on YouTube that weren't even necessarily competitive quality, but I still had a following enough that I made a living doing it. I think they were very upset about that. You know? El Real Pet Chicken did another super chat and says, and Bison couldn't handle the BBC. The British Broadcasting Corporation are a bunch of badasses, so I stay away from them. Local Nomad, see, I agree. He says, I think I would have made a good, like caster, someone who does commentary and insight. I would definitely, for the older games, anything like Marvel vs. Capcom 1 and 2, or Super Turbo, or even Third Strike, to some extent. Like, those games, I know enough about that I know I could do good commentary. Absolutely, I know that. But...
got some damage on Dante rather than Phoenix, but now Justin still...
Oh, here comes Dark Phoenix.
Good snap out right there. Brought in Dark Phoenix when she lost...
Super! Oh my god, so much damage! That's it, Justin has no health! That's it! Yeah!
You gotta listen to me because I'm not talking over you. Don't talk over me.
Okay.
I'm serious. It sounds horrible.
Okay.
The thing is that, like, I don't know, it just became, the community became so toxic towards me that I just didn't want anything to do with it anymore, so I just fucking said, fuck this, I'll do variety videos, every once in a while if there's a fighting game I'll cover it, but I'm just never gonna care about doing things competitively. Alright, that was a good, I would say this was a pretty good session of Street Fighter, even though we did have some issues early on, getting matches, and staying in a lobby that would work. I would say definitely it picked up around the second half. Remember, I got into that lobby where we got quite a lot of matches in. I'd like to say thanks to everyone who chilled. Thanks to everyone. By the way, this was the first time we did Street Fighter with the sub-only mode enabled. And if you guys didn't notice, it was actually very controllable, the chat. We had a lot of fun conversation. You guys were asking me questions, and I was actually able to give you intelligent answers because it wasn't crazy amount of people spamming the chat with bullshit. Right? Seriously, like, there was so much fucking bullshit previously here on the past couple of weeks on YouTube, and now that we got the sub-only mode in here, I think it worked way better, right? I hope you guys agree with me. Everyone, please have a good evening. Relax. If you missed any portion of this stream, I'm going to upload this gameplay right now to DSP Gaming right here, and I shall return tomorrow with Ratchet & Clank. Everyone, have a good night. I'll see you in the AM, alright? Peace out, everyone. Later.